In the last video lectures, we discussed about the intrinsic semiconductors, which are elemental semiconducting materials. The elemental semiconductors are defined as the single species of atoms such as silicon, germanium and tin in column 4, and selenium and tellurium in column 6 are said to be the elemental semiconductors. In the last video lecture, we calculated the density of charge carriers in a conduction band and the density of holes in a valency band, and also we calculated the position of Fermi level in an intrinsic semiconductor, that is EF is equal to EC plus EV by 2, and also we calculated the intrinsic carrier concentration per unit volume, that is said to be the intrinsic carrier density. So based on these calculated parameters, we are in a position to calculate the conductivity of a semiconducting material. Okay. Now, the electrical conductivity of a semiconducting material, we are calculating now the electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity of a semiconductor. So the electrical conductivity of a semiconductor, sigma, can be written as the number of electrons in a conduction band multiplied with the charge and its mobility, plus the number of holes in a valency band multiplied with charge with the mobility of the holes. In an intrinsic semiconductor, the number of electrons in a conduction band, the number of holes in a valency band can be termed as intrinsic carrier concentration. This is intrinsic carrier concentration per unit volume. So we write sigma is equal to ENI and its charge mobility. Mobility of the electron, the mobility of the hole. The mobility can be defined as the velocity acquired by the charge carrier under unit potential gradient, that is defined as mobility. The mobility is related with respect to the interaction of charge carriers with the lattice waves or phonons. So if we use the last class notes or the intrinsic carrier density, the Ni can be redefined as 2 times of 2 pi kBT by h square whole to the power of 3 by 2. And the effective mass of the electron, the effective mass of the hole, exponential minus Eg by 2kBT. This is the last class notes. If I substitute 2 in 1, the sigma, if you use all these things, 2 times of this by h square whole to power of 3 by 2, and m h star 3 by 4 exponential minus eg by 2kBT, and charge and mobility. From this we can see that the conductivity is directly proportional to the negative exponential of band gap, and directly proportional to the mobility, and directly proportional to the effective mass of the electron and the hole. If you consider this particular parameter, these are the constant apart from the temperature, this is the constant and these are the constants. So like the sigma, I'll keep all these things in the constant, exponential A into exponential minus Eg by 2kBT. If I take the logarithm of this, long sigma is equal to long A minus Eg by 2 k b t. If you plot the graph between the ln sigma versus 1 by t, the conductivity is increases with increase in a temperature in a semiconducting material. So based on this particular formula, conductivity, we can calculate the energy gap of a given semiconducting material using four probe method. Here I'm calculating the energy gap of a given semiconducting material. Energy gap of a given semiconducting material. Generally, we use four probe method to calculate the energy gap of a given semiconducting material. There, we are calculating the resistivity by using the dimensions as well as the voltage and current. So, sigma is equal to A exponential minus Eg by 2 kVt. So, the resistivity can be defined as the reciprocal of conductivity. So the resistivity is also can be written as R is the area of cross section per unit length is equal to exponential minus Eg by 2 kBt. From this I will write, so this A is the area and this is the constant. I'll use small a for this, for area. This is said to be the area. This is set to be the length of a given semiconductor specimen where A is the constant, where Eg is the band gap, where Kb is the Boltzmann constant, where T is the temperature in Kelvin. So from this I will write R is equal to capital A is a constant, L by area, exponential minus Eg by 2 kBt. Anyway, L is a length of a given semiconductor is a constant, area is also constant. So I will write this complete thing into the constant C. So R is equal to, I will write C exponential minus Eg by 2 kVt. So here resistance, sorry, is a plus, this is a plus and this is going to be a plus, inverse of this is going to be plus. So go for logarithm R is equal to, apply the logarithm ln C plus Eg by 2 kVt. So this resistance can be calculated using four probe method. So in the four probe method, we are taking a semiconductor specimen. We are taking the four semiconducting specimen of thickness and length and area. So we are passing the current. We are measuring the voltage between the two points here. This is the four probe method of a given semiconducting material. We are passing the current and we are measuring the so like this, it will be like this. The four contacts will be there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Give the voltage, measure the, give pass the current, measure the voltage. From this we can calculate the resistance. If you plot the graph between ln of R versus 1 by T. I'm taking this on y-axis, this 1 by T on x-axis. So we get the graph appears to be like this. If you take the slope between these points dy by dx, so dy by dx I'll get Eg, energy gap by 2k. K is the Boltzmann constant. this is said to be the slope from the graph. So I'll get Eg is equal to the slope multiplied with the Boltzmann constant. So we'll get the answer in terms of electron volts. If the evoked value, the energy gap, comes under 0.72 electron volts, this belongs to the germanium. If it is belong to 1.12 electron volts, this belongs to the silicon. So this is the energy gap of a given semiconducting material that can be obtained by using the conductivity. Then that is transformed into the resistivity. The resistivity depends upon area and the length. So like this, the procedure we can calculate. So this is the experimental graph, which is obtained by using the four probe method experiment. There we are passing the current, measuring the voltage. The given dimensions are given. So from this we will get the ln R, then temperature, vary the temperature. So we will get the straight line. From this we can calculate the given energy gap of a semiconducting material. Thank you.